In this session, you will learn about Class B output stage amplifiers. Class A amplifiers' operating point is in the center of the load line and conduct for the entire input cycle. So about half the supply voltage is dropped across the transistor. This voltage drop and the current produce a power loss in the transistors. The power conversion efficiency of Class A power amplifier in the ideal case is just 25%. Biasing an amplifier at cutoff saves power. In Class B amplifier, the operating point is located in the cutoff region. Hence, the transistor conducts only for 180 degree or half of the input signal, making Class B amplifier more efficient as compared to the Class A amplifier. However, to get the output signal for the complete cycle of the input signal, a complementary pair of transistors, an NPN and PNP transistors, are connected in such a way that both the transistors cannot conduct simultaneously. In this circuit, when the input voltage Vi is zero, both transistors are cut off and the output voltage is V0 equal to zero. Now consider the case when Vi is positive. When Vi exceeds above 0.5 volt, Qn conducts and operates as an emitter follower. So this is evident by applying your KVL to the output side, V0 equal to Vi minus VBEn. So if you neglect VBEn, you can observe that V0 exactly follows the input voltage here. So here Qn supplies the load current. So the emitter base junction of Qp will be reverse biased by the base emitter voltage of the transistor Qn. So thus Qp will be in cutoff. So V0 can be expressed as VCC minus VCE. N represents the NPN transistor. The maximum output voltage is obtained when Qn is in saturation. So therefore, V0 max is given by VCC minus VCE N sat. So that is when Qn transistor is in saturation. Okay. Now consider if the input goes negative by more than 0.5 volt. So in that case, Qp turns on and acts as an emitter follower. So from the expression again, so V0 will be equal to Vi plus VBE of the PNP transistor. So this shows that the transistor acts as an emitter follower. So V0 follows Vi. So in this case, Qp supplies the load current and the NPN transistor is completely cut off. So the output is given by V0 equal to minus VCC plus VCE. So here you can observe that it is VEC, the emitter collector voltage drop across the transistor and PNP transistor. So the again, the maximum output on the negative side, that is the minimum output is obtained when QP is in saturation. Now, in Class B output stage, the transistors are biased at zero current and conduct only when the input signal is present. So Qn or the NPN transistor pushes the current into the load when Vi is positive, that is acting as a source. And whereas during the negative, Qp pulls the current from the load when the input voltage is negative, that is it acts as a sink. So this configuration is called as push-pull configuration. Now let us try to plot the transfer characteristics of Class B stage. First, consider the positive half cycle. So let Vi equal to 0.5 volt. So up to Vi equal to 0.5 volt, the transistor Qn and Qp is completely cut off and V0 equal to 0 volt. So that is shown here. So for an input of plus 0.5 volt up to that, the output is zero. When Vi is greater than 0.5 volt, then the output follows the input with the positive limit of VCC minus VCN saturation, which we have seen in the last slide. So this is a maximum positive limit. Okay. Now for negative half cycles, up to VI equal to minus 0.5, the transistor QP and QN is cut off. So again, V naught is equal to 0 volt. When VI exceeds minus 0.5 volt, then the output follows input with the negative limit of minus VCC plus VEC sat. So as we discussed in the previous slide again. So this is the negative limit or the minimum output voltage which occurs on the negative side. Notice that there exists a range of VI for which the output is completely zero. So this is the range of input voltage for which both the transistors are cut off. So the output voltage is zero here. Now this range of VI for which transistors are cut off is called a dead band. So the amplifier has a dead band of about 0.5 volt here and 0.5, so it's totally 1 volt. So in practical cases, it can be considered as 0.6 volt also, because we know that for a silicon transistor conducts for a VB of 0.7 volt. So approximately it has a dead band of 1 volt. Now this results in crossover distortion on the output signal. So you can look at the output signal. Due to the dead band which is available here, the output is not smooth. So you can observe a small distortion over here. This distortion is called as crossover distortion. This distorts, it happens as the signal is crossing from one transistor to the other transistor. And this completely distorts the output signal, and the non-linearity makes class B push-pull amplifier unacceptable for some power applications. Now, what is the efficiency of class B amplifier? To determine the efficiency of class B amplifier, first let us neglect the crossover distortion and consider the case as an output sine wave with peak value of V naught cap. Now we know that the load power is equal to the RMS value square divided by the load resistance, that is V naught cap divided by root 2 the whole square divided by RL. So that is equal to 1 by 2 into V naught cap divided by RL. The current drawn from each supply will consist of half the sine wave. So the average current drawn from the each of the two power supply is given by 1 by pi into V naught cap divided by RL. This is because each transistor will be conducting only for 180 degree. So it is 1 by pi. The average power drawn from each of the two power supplies will be the same. So the power drawn from the supply will be equal to V into I. So the current we know it is 1 by pi into V naught cap divided by RL into VCC is the power drawn from both the supplies. Okay. So what is the total power drawn from the supply? So the total power drawn from the power supply is 2 into V naught cap divided by pi into RL into VCC. So this is the total power drawn from the power supplies. With the load power and supply power, let us try to find the power conversion efficiency of class B output stage. So when we substitute these two expressions, your efficiency will be obtained as pi by 4 into V naught cap divided by VCC. So from this expression, it is obvious that if we want to obtain a maximum efficiency, then the peak value of the output waveform, that is V naught cap, should be equal to VCC. So in that case, the maximum value can be computed as pi by 4, which is equal to 78.5%, or it is equal to 79%. So this is the efficiency of a class B output stage amplifier, and this value is much larger than the efficiency of class A amplifier. Now let us discuss about the power dissipation of class P output stage. When transistor QN is on, the maximum power dissipation is given by product of voltage and current. So since the transistor NPN transistor and PNP transistor conducts only for half sine wave, the average voltage is equal to VCC by pi and the average current is equal to VCC by pi into RL. So on taking a product of these two, we get the maximum power dissipation in NPN transistor QN is equal to VCC squared divided by pi square into R. So similarly, maximum power dissipation in QP is also equal to VCC squared into divided by pi square into R. So the maximum average power dissipation in the circuit is equal to 2 into VCC squared divided by pi square into R. So this is a maximum average power dissipation in a class B output stage. The power dissipation of class B stage versus amplitude of output sinusoid is plotted here. So at the point of maximum power dissipation, you can observe that the efficiency is equal to 50%. And you can also observe that increasing V naught beyond 2 into VCC divided by pi decreases the power dissipated in the class B stage while increasing the load power. And at V naught equal to VCC, you get the maximum efficiency of 79%. So to summarize, class B stage amplifier has a power conversion efficiency of 78.5%. Even though the percentage of efficiency is high, the circuit suffers from crossover distortion. So the output will be completely distorted. So because of these reasons, the class B amplifier is not suitable for power applications. The next topic of discussion in class is class AB output stage amplifier. The problem of crossover distortion due to deadband and non-linearity in the circuit is eliminated by providing a forward bias for the base emitter junction of the transistors so that the transistors are not in cutoff for a range of input voltages. So this results in a class AB amplifier and the operating point of class AB is near cutoff. The complementary pair of transistors are biased at a small non-zero current. Consider a small bias voltage VBB that is applied between the bases of the NPN transistor and the PNP transistor. A voltage VBB by 2 appears across the base emitter junction of NPN transistor and the base emitter junction of PNP transistor. The value of VBB is chosen such a way that VBB is equal to the voltage that is just required to turn on the both the transistors, that is VBE for the NPN transistor plus VBE for the PNP transistor. Now when the input voltage goes positive, so that is when VI goes positive, so this transistor QN will be in conduction. So when we apply KVL, we can write that V naught equal to VI plus VBB by 2 minus VBE. So this is a bias voltage. So this voltage is approximately equal to VBE. So in that case, the output voltage is exactly equal to the input voltage. That is, in other words, we can say that the output follows input at almost same value. For positive input voltages, the load current is supplied by the NPN transistor, which acts as emitter follower with the positive limit VCC minus VCN saturation. And for the negative input voltages, load current is supplied by an NPN transistor, which acts as an emitter follower with the limit on the negative side to be equal to minus VCC plus VCE saturation. Now we can conclude that class AB stage operates in a same manner as class B circuit with one important exception, that is for VI between minus 0.5 volt and plus 0.5 volt, both the transistor conduct here. and one of the two transistors take over the operation. So here the transition is smooth and the crossover distortion is almost totally eliminated. To summarize, a class AB amplifier does not have as much efficiency as class B amplifier. Its efficiency is better than that of class A stage. It is a compromise class that provides minimum distortion and reasonable efficiency. It is the most popular class for high power audio applications. With this, we complete power amplifiers. Thank you.